So he gives the guys swords and shields, spears and machetes. No. What does he give them? He gives them, as you wish, pottery materials and an instrument. What? Well, that's the, as you wish, you gotta do the fire part with the fire. They have nothing to fight with. There are 300 of them going up against 32,001 at least people with torches, jars. That's good for killing one person. Like, a jar could take out maybe one. So we can kill 300 people at this point. We've got torches. You can set something on fire. That's cool. And trumpets, so they can have fun singing songs on their way there. But they have nothing to fight with past that. It's a suicide mission. Completely. Except Gideon did not present it to them as a suicide mission. It was not presented as, like, this is the day you're going to die. Because Gideon had full confidence that he was going to win. Because the Lord had given him that confidence and that proof. And so he built up his men with that same confidence and faith. He didn't come in and say, let's go fight, it's time. He said, the Lord has given Midian into our hands. So Gideon and the 100 men who were with him came to the outskirts of the camp at the beginning of the middle watch, when they had just set watch, and they blew their trumpets and smashed the jars with their that were in their hands. Then the three companies blew the trumpets and broke the jars. They held in their left hands the torches and in their right hands the trumpets to blow, and they cried out, a sword for the Lord and for Gideon. And every man stood in his place around the camp, and all the army ran. They cried out and fled. And when they blew the 300 trumpets, the Lord set every man's sword against his comrade and against all the army. And the army fled everywhere. They just went everywhere. And Gideon sent messengers throughout all the hill country of Ephraim, saying, come down against the Midianites and capture the waters against them for as far as all these places. So the men from all these places came and they captured the water from all those places. And they captured the two princes of Midian, and they killed them, and they pursued Midian, and they brought them the heads of the people they killed. So... So basically, they stand around in a circle. They throw their water bottle on the ground, hold fire up in the sky, and blow trumpets really loud. All they've got. And God, who was with them, did the rest. God had them all freak out because they were sleeping. Completely startled away. They just like slit each other's throats. So Gideon and his men stand there and watch because they have fire so they can see. They get to watch everybody just like destroy themselves in the middle and take off running because they're scared. And they're like, all right, guys, come on in. And they finish up. No one did this hand-to-hand combat, scary, risk your life business. The Lord did it all. It just took courage and faith. This is not that long after Gideon was hanging out, hiding. And God said, mighty warrior. This was the progression. He didn't jump straight to 300 men against all of these Midianites and other places. It started with, go home. God took Gideon's identity and told him, go be that man out. And when he was that man at home, then God had him take it to the rest of the city. It is time for us to take our identities and to go. And for those of you who have already been taking your identity and going home, it's time to go into the city. So if you're like, I've been doing it at home. I am who God says I am at home. Great. Keep going. If you're like, I am who God says I am, and I'm just waiting for the city to recognize me. But if my family knew, they'd kill me. Go home. Let your family want to kill you. Because God just might use you to defend your family against Midian. What are some of the things that you guys are getting out of that? As we like now read multiple chapters. There's more. Gideon keeps defeating things. Gideon dies.
And then it all goes back to darkness.
Oh,
like, literally, it's just the day after he dies, it all goes back to bed.
Rough life! Gideon's awesome. But he's so faithful. So what we're